autograph, and I thought I had it somewhere around here, but it's probably in the attic. I really ought to go up there and clean it out one of these days. I have so many little keepsakes up there. You're paying attention, right? Say, what's my favorite flavor of ice cream? So you are listening, how wonderful. You're an even better listener than my old pet rack, Beasto. Beasto was such a sweetie. You ever had a pet rack? If you can tame them, they are the sweetest pet you'll ever have. He used to just sit on my shoulder and bite chunks of flesh out of my neck to pass the time. I still remember the way he used to tweet. He went, tweet, tweet. It was so cute. I had a conversation with him once. I said, Mr. Beasto. He liked being called Mr. Beasto. It made him feel like an aristocrat. I said, Mr. Beasto, you're looking very cute today. And he said, oh, thank you. That's so nice. Or he tweeted in a way that made me know that's how he felt. And then he lowered his little head like he was taking a bow. It was adorable. Beasto was my third pet rack. First, I had Woody. He got hit by a train. Then I had Anita. She got shot up trying to take vengeance on the train that killed Woody. And then I found Beasto making little poops on the windmill outside our house. After Mr. Torg and I wrestled her to the ground, I did a flying pile driver off a nearby tower tree, got him straight in the spine, and brought him down. We brought him in and fed him some skag steaks until he decided he loved us. I still miss Beasto sometimes. He just died of old age. Rack don't live much longer than a few years, but I treasured the time we had together. Poor Mr. Torg. When Beasto died, he cried for a week. The kids made fun of him at school, but I told him not to pay them any mind.
Being in touch with your emotions is not a character flaw!
That's right, High Five. Is something wrong? You look confused, Vault Hunter. Oh, you probably haven't heard anyone call Mr. Torg High Five before. The world may know him as Mr. Torg, but the Flexingtons always refer to him using his middle name. It's a Flexington family tradition, after all, to use your grandfather or grandmother's name as your own middle name. And my husband, High Five Flexington, God rest his soul, was the best grandfather Mr. Torg could have asked for before he passed. He taught Mr. Torg dang near everything he knew about firearms. Without High Five's teachings, I don't think the Torg Corporation would exist at all. Gosh, I still remember the first gun Mr. Torg tried to make after his parents died. A Jacob's shotgun with a stick of dynamite attached to the barrel. Torg nearly blew his face off, but he got up, dusted his mustache off, and swore that by the time he reached the age of 11, he would make a gun that fired explosions without killing the operator. And by golly, he did! It took a couple of dozen prototypes before he got the right combination of gun parts and explosives, right? But once he did, woo-wee! Ha! I'll never forget the plume of smoke that used to be my neighbor's homestead. They were jerks, though, so it's okay. Gosh, I've been talking your ear off for some time, haven't I? It's so kind of you to listen for this long. I've taken up too much of your time already. Please, don't feel like you have to stick around any longer. As a matter of fact, take this for giving this old woman some company. Woo! You're even more attractive than Mr. Torg said you were. I've got another story for you, but I'd like to tell it to all of your friends at once. An old lady like me has to save her voice, you know. Oh, you still want to talk with me? How incredibly sweet of you. Say, you'll never guess who I saw today. Captain Scarlet. She was robbing my retirement home with a few other brigands, and I recognized her for her wanted poster, and I said, oh, hey, you fought the Vault Hunter, didn't you? And she bowed all elegantly and said something like, indeed I did, madam, and said that you were really good at fighting and that you beat her fair and square. She didn't seem to harbor much of a grudge about it. Nice girl. You should think about meeting up with her again if you're not shacked up with anybody, you know? I mean, of course, you probably are. Gorgeous hunk of a Vault Hunter like you. I bet you're beating away suitors left and right. Look, you're blushing! Oh, I could just eat you up. Mr. Torg was so scared of trying to get a date for such a long time. He used to go to parties in high school and just stand in the back without talking to anybody.
I am an introvert!
I tried to tell worry about chasing love. If you chase your dreams, then love will follow. See, that's the thing people don't get. You watch Echo films and they're just awful. They teach you that the only way to be with someone is just to pursue them over and over until they decide they like you. In reality, you know when you like someone almost immediately. You can't really convince somebody to fall in love with you. You just look like a stalker. But if you do things that you're interested in, like making guns that explode or killing mercenaries, then people will see that confidence and skill you have and they'll be attracted to it. There's always a fine line between that kind of confidence and narcissism, you know? There's nothing worse than somebody who wants to be famous. I remember when Mr. Torg first sold his weapons tech to that board of directors, he was pretty egocentric for a while, taking pictures of himself and posting them to the EchoNet all the time, trying to hobnob with every celebrity that used his weapons. He came back home one day with a supermodel under each arm, and I said, Mr. Torg, what are you doing? You've lost sight of who you are. It's been weeks since you actually created a new gun, I said. And it was true. He'd been more obsessed with being well-known for doing something great than with actually doing something great.
It was a dark point in my life.
Thankfully, High Five listened to me and got to work on what would eventually become the Kerblaster. You a fan of the Kerblaster? That was always my favorite. That and the Flacker, which I know a lot of people hate. But there's more to combat than just brute efficiency in this old lady's eyes. Style counts for something. And there's nothing quite like filling the air with tiny little explosions. It's like a fireworks show, except the deaths aren't as sad and unexpected. Actually, that reminds me, now that you're here, I wanted to throw some ideas at you for feedback. I'm a playwright in my spare time, and I'm trying to write a story about an up-and-coming tournament fighter who tries to find love in a gladiatorial arena. And I figure you've got a lot of experience, so your feedback could really be valuable. So the play is called Broken Hearts and Broken Necks. Scene 1. Fade in on an arena just after a battle. Body parts litter the stage. A lone warrior stands in the middle of the stage, a spotlight illuminating her blood-stained arm. She stands, holding her sword triumphantly aloft. Valkyrie.
Is there no warrior who can challenge me? Must I be destined to spend my life as the strongest, the bravest, the most invincible warrior this galaxy has seen? For I am Valkyrie, scourge of the gladiatorial games!
Exit Valkyrie as she shakes her head in despair. From stage left, enter. A janitor.
Oh no, you're leaving? I won't take up any more of your time.
I've got another story for you, but I'd like to tell it to all of your friends at once. An old lady like me has to save her voice, you know. Oh, you still want to talk with me? How incredibly sweet of you. Say, you'll never guess who I saw today. Captain Scarlet. She was robbing my retirement home with a few other brigands, and I recognized her from her wanted poster, and I said, oh, hey, you fought the Vault Hunter, didn't you? And she bowed all elegantly and said something like, indeed I did, madam, and said that you were really good at fighting and that you beat her fair and square. She didn't seem to harbor much of a grudge about it. Nice girl. You should think about meeting up with her again if you're not shacked up with anybody, you know? I mean, of course, you probably are. Gorgeous hunk of a vault hunter like you. I bet you're beating away suitors left and right. Look, you're blushing. Oh, I could just eat you up. Mr. Torg was so scared of trying to get a date for such a long time. He used to go to parties in high school and just stand in the back without talking to anybody.
I am an introvert!
I tried to tell him, I said, don't worry about chasing love. If you chase your dreams, then love will follow. See, that's the thing people don't get. You watch Echo films and they're just awful. They teach you that the only way to be with someone is just to pursue them over and over until they decide they like you. In reality, you know when you like someone almost immediately. You can't really convince somebody to...